Hey everyone, this is the Lego NEXO Knight set called Ruina's Lock and Roller. Not Rock and Roller, even though she does fight for the Stone Army. Lock and Roller. The pun in this case is that she's actually pulling along a prisoner transport carriage. So there's somebody locked up inside of that. As the standard gray and purple color scheme for the season. Also a little bit of iciness with some light blue elements in there for the front, a little bit around the side, and also for the hubcaps. I guess that could be a representation of lightning, which is so common for these baddies, but kind of looks icy to me, especially with the crystalline formation on the front. This thing looks pretty nice from the back, actually, just looking at the shapes of it. You know, I'm still not a big fan of the color schemes for the Stone Warrior clan this season around, but the build is looking pretty nice here. It has a little cheater third wheel in the front, so if you want to detach that from what's pulling it, you can, and it'll just stay behind. This vehicle is called a Gargoyle Bike, so it's a gargoyle turned into a two-wheeled vehicle, so it's kind of like a living stone statue motorcycle. And this actually has a decent amount of articulation on the front, because you can move these kind of arm or wing elements up and down. The fingers articulate independently, and the head turns from side to side. So it almost looks like it has a little bit of life in there, but the eyes look dead and maybe like possessed. So I think that's a pretty good balance, you know, between making it look like it has some life, but at the same time making it look like it's a magical specter type of thing. Nice use of these purple colored flippers for the back. The rest of it back here doesn't look that impressive to me. Also, it runs on hard plastic wheels, and those don't get great traction on hard surfaces, and they do pick up a lot of dust and fuzz from carpets. The figure just stands there on a couple of studs, so it's not too difficult to remove it or to put it back into place. And I guess you can make this lean over in turns as well, so that also helps with the appearance of liveliness and motion. Surprisingly, the bike does not have any shooters or anything, but the carriage has a major action feature built into it, and that's for helping a person to escape from inside. Around the back, you know, there's just a door, and usually what they would do is let you pull the door down. They don't really have a good accommodation for that with this one, but instead, the forbidden power on its shield up on the pole kind of acts like a banner, but it is the trigger for the action feature. So you would probably try with Aaron to shoot at it, but I've tried this and you really don't get enough power out of that bolt to make this get activated. So I recommend putting Aaron onto his hoverboard, you know, which is his shield, and just try to find a way to get past the defenses and hit this thing. And when you hit it, it acts as a trigger and opens up a panel underneath, actually drops down whoever or whatever is inside. Now, in order to get that figure posed so that you could see it from the front, that nice trapped in ice kind of look, I needed to put it on the two studs that are in the front that are there just for exactly that. When a figure is on those two studs, you drop down the trap door under here, and kind of the person just hits their head. They don't even do that. You know, they just kind of sit there awkwardly. So if you want this action feature to work right, don't put them on the studs, which means it's going to be very difficult to get them to stand up, so you're not going to get a good pose out of it. It's a compromise. It's also difficult to get fingers in there. I think even young fingers, small fingers, would have trouble. Maybe get her to sit down. See, this is difficult. This is awkward, and there's no easy way to remove the roof. Of course you can do it, it's Lego, but I would have liked to have some. Look at this, it just doesn't want to stay. There are no studs here, this is all flat. So okay, she's just gonna sit, that's it. I'm done with this. So this is how it would work. You hit that and she falls out the back. By the way, that is a scannable forbidden power, and it is Wrecking Wrath. Here's a closer look at Ruina herself with her lightning scythe, a built-up thing. Usually I like weapons like that are, you know, reasonable in size and look like a familiar shape. I actually don't like this one that much because it really only works from one side. On the box, they have it built the other way around, but they had to flip a part in order to make that work. Because like this, see, that just doesn't look good from that side. Maybe I'm a little bit biased by that. But the figure, I think, beyond the weapon, the figure, I think, looks really good. The print on the lower half of the torso and on the front of the leg or skirt piece looks very vibrant. Looks like there's real color and light coming out of it. So that's nicely done. Also, there's a good amount of detail in the print in the face and a lot of expressiveness. You know, it really looks like she is passionate in her hate. You know, it just really comes through the eyes and all the lines. Now, this hairpiece surprised me mostly in its material. Now, that's a very nice mold, but I expected it to be a soft rubber piece. It is not. It is a hard plastic piece. Interesting. It also has no attachment points for, like, Friends-style accessories or anything. It's just what you see here. Really good mold, especially with the waves going down the back. There is an alternate face under here, and there's decent print on the back of the torso, but because this is a hard plastic piece, head likes to come up with it. Let me fix that. There we go. That's her evil smile face. Another good one, you know, that looks serious. It looks very present. Here's Aaron with the latest version of his bow, just uses the new spear tip pieces in trans neon reddish orange to give it a little bit different look. His one NEXO power included in this set is Gorilla Roar. Maybe a little bit of shades of the Legend Beasts from Legend of Chima. And as usual, I need to take a bunch of stuff off for you to see more of the detail. There we go. Yep, this is another good set of prints in how they're applied, but they just don't look as realistic and they don't really pop as much. I think they just look more 2D and comic than the ones that they use for the Stone Army or for the bad guys just in general in this series. There's his alternate cheesing face. Here's the Queen, fully armored up with all of her golden garb. And this is a good match for the Armored King that they did for last season. Very matchy-matchy, though not using the exact same pieces, so there's still some uniqueness to all of the parts there. They just look good together. And this does use the pearl gold color, quite a bit of it, as well as painted on metallic gold. So that's a nicer look, a little closer to a champagne gold with that. Just shines so much more. I do very much appreciate the recolor of the main armor piece, the main Nexo Knight's armor piece in pearl gold. I think that looks really good and should be super useful for a lot of custom stuff. I do believe this is the same head that the Queen had on the first version of her, and that goes for both faces. It's a medium azure torso, main torso piece. But I wanted you to see the shine off all the gold and silver print there on the back as well. That's pretty slick. And again, yeah, same face for the front. And let you see the rest of the detail of that nicely printed torso. So to summarize, I like the figures, all three of them. I like the poseability of the front of the bike. The back of it doesn't look as great. The carriage, I think, actually looks very nice, a nice build there, but playing with that, and especially working with a figure inside of it, is very frustrating to me. Another thing that's frustrating is that they're once again using the tired, old damsel in distress trope. I'm just tired of that. It's not a political thing, it's not some social statement thing, it's been done so many times. Come up with something else. Retire that one for a couple years at least. Mixed thoughts from me on this one, but hopefully the video has given you information to help you make your own decision about it. And if you have anything you'd like to say about it right now, feel free to leave a comment down below. Thank you very much for watching, and stay tuned for more content from me, because more is always on the way. Talk to you again soon.